他的交警常常被后者的政治倾向或政治倾向所转。另外一点就是副议题公共议题非常紧张，他没有办法分散的选民没有办法分散出阅读这么多，
但是
他
的
是
小
的。Okay, this is Issue Taiwan, and his intention is to let the election back this discussion back to all the issues of the promises. Actually, and why we couldn't discuss on specific issues is one of the reasons is because we cannot individually choose our side on specific issues, we can just choose the candidates.And another one is, for example, most of the voters are have their own jobs, so they couldn't spend much time as students to understand all the issues, preciously.
所以我们要做的，第一点是很多去那边的社会实践在进行，就是把复杂的公共的资料其实分散在网络上或者地方，把它整理起来，然后视觉化。那这是很多人在做，就像他的朋友，这也是我们会合作的对象。那另外一点，我们也会推动公民教育，会找一些讲师，慢慢去跟大家解释这些资料它的背后的政治意
义。Basically, we know GovZero has already been organizing all of the data scattering on the internet to let complex information become more precise and conscious for others to understand. And on the other hand, they are trying to do citizen education to teach people to interpret the messages behind those information.
那最重要的是，我们还会增加另外一个功能，就是让我们会做一个平台，然后把像他这样的作品结合在一起，然后同时我们会对于这些承诺，然后提供网友的投票，就某种意义上我们在做政策的民调，而且并且是在选举让候选人的选民在选举之前就知道大众对于这个承诺或这个议题的意见。
Basically, we try to combine both the promise tracker and with online votes to let elect candidates to understand of the electors' decisions and their willings on specific issue, and 还有什么？就是除了投票之外 ，to combine those to combine promise tracker with voting and to reflect the whole citizens' will.
So they're going to be built as a complementary tool set.
Yes. 希望可以结合更多。
And he's also building a platform with which will combine not only PPT, but also all other tools and information on a single entrance portal.
因为对台湾的选民来说，政治是一个有点半封闭的领域，他们不了解里面是什么。那我们想要结合已经在努力发掘政治内部资料，然后把它做更前行、更视觉化的呈现，并且给这些网友有表达意见的。
Actually, to most of the common Taiwanese, political is much opaque to them, and
not just Taiwan.
So, to let electors understand and to let them read the messages is important.
而且最重要就是在选举投票完之前就让他们知道，他们不用等到投票出来。
And these issues and these the public will need to be expressed before the election to let candidates to choose their own side.
So have you looked at the Populous project?
Populous, 其实就是外面有摆贴纸那个 Populous.
And what they've done is they've developed a set of standards to track issues.But then they've developed a methodology for determining whether a candidate feels strongly, moderately, or weakly about an issue. Because politicians always say the right thing, but they seldom really mean what they say. So this is a way of tracking them over time. And they've developed a methodology for mass application of the standard. And then they've also developed some interwoven toolkits, so SAILT, I think Gov.0 already uses. And the tracking one is now about to come online. And I think it's called StandIt or something. Something like that, but it might feed into your project.
Actually, Populous.
You're going further than they are, but there might be some foundation work that they've done that you can build on top of.
可以找一下去年那个 GDB 上面的那个，因为 Populous 有来。
Here it is.
Yeah, Populous. Last year's Gov.0 summit, Populous has had part. Yeah, and they provided some interesting insights.
There's a crazy guy called Tony Borden, who you should connect with. He's a rebel Scottishman. Because he makes so much trouble in England that he now lives in Estonia. But he's driving that project. And he's very, very keen to find collaborators. So, plus he's got a small amount of money. So if you need help, then he might have money to help. He's trying to build a global community.
Wow.
Pleasure.
Thank you. Let's see if outside the conference.